Hi, my name is Kenny. In my last video, we talked about how hard drives work. In this video, we will be talking about how DVD players and computers work. So it looks like on this one, these things right here, they just lift out. So I'm gonna go ahead and take these off if I can get them to come off. There we go. Now I gotta get this thing out. So let's figure out where the screws are for this thing. So normally this would be really easy to do, but HP made it really hard and it's catching on something and I can't see what it's catching on. And I can't open it from the other side because there's no screws that go to the other side. Not that I'm aware of. The screws are for this thing, but I can't find any screws to detach the other side. So I can't look at it from the other side, and I don't see any screws on here. I see the little pins, but I don't see any screws. So this is a complaint that I'm making to HP. If you're gonna make something that people wanna buy, make it so they can take it apart and put new parts in. So I took the power box out of its place and I was trying to figure out what it was keeping it from moving, because it was like, just like this one, this thing, it was stuck in place somewhere and I couldn't figure out where it was. Turns out it was this the whole time and I couldn't move it to the side because of this. So yeah, that took me a minute or two to figure out where it was getting stuck, and now all I have left is to find out where this is getting stuck. Because it's catching on something, and I tried to push it out the other end, and it just won't go. It won't go out the other end. So I'm gonna have to figure out where it's getting stuck. Also, I'm gonna go ahead and unplug the wires just to be safe, because I don't want to pull them. So I know it took me a while to figure it out, but these ones actually do go out the front. So I thought it went out the other side, but I was wrong. Now let's take a look at how it works. Before we learn about DVD players and how they work, let's learn about CDs, compact discs. Here's one by Kenny G. This is called Silhouette, the album. So I'm gonna open it up, and this is a CD, AKA compact disc. I'm gonna show you the other one. This is by Kenny G. This is called Breathless. I'm gonna open this up. It's the same thing, just with different songs on it. What is a CD made of? A CD usually has a label on the front and a shiny side on the back. The shiny side is the important part because that's where the laser reads the code. Before CDs were invented, music was typically stored on one of two things. One of them is a record. You might be able to find Elton John or even the Beatles on there. The other is called a cassette tape. Now, what a cassette tape was, it was designed to play movies and music, but the problem with that was that they stretched or even snapped easily. When CDs came along, they fixed that problem. There's two main types of cassettes. A cassette tape, which plays music, and is very compact versus a video cassette, which is very large and bulky and plays movies. Now, why am I talking about cassettes and records? Well, that's what led to the invention of the CD. The first CD was invented in the 1960s by James Russell, thanks to him, but the CD player wasn't invented until the 1980s.